I want to do a little comparison between an old Makarov CO2 conversion and a newer one. On the right is the old one and on the left the newer one. This one is from 1999. I think the T stands for year in Russian and the 99 is a production year. So this one is made in 1999 and this one is made in 2009. The first differences you will notice is the different slide shape and the different grip on the older one. This one, the older one, has another slide shape with the beard on it, I think this is called. And this one has also the original Makarov PMM grip with the lug to attach a cord. Whereas on the newer one, the slide was rounded off underneath the barrel. And the grip is made out of cheap and brittle feeling plastic, and it also sounds hollow when you operate the gun. You can hear that this really sounds cheap. On the older model, the sound is like on the original Makarov. And doesn't sound so cheap. The other differences are that the bluing on the newer ones look muddy. They have brown spots which you can't see right now because of the light, but there are brown spots all over the slide, which the older one hasn't. This is a really deep black finish, which looks almost perfect. Then there are some minor differences in the finish. The finish on the safety levers on the older model is also better. You can see this and this. And on the hammer there's a cutout on the newer models, which the older has not. Then the anti-reflective stripe on the top of the slide is broader on the older one. Also the rear side is broader on the older Makarov. Then when you look at the muzzle, you can also see a difference. On the left is the newer model and on the right the older one. The newer one has an asymmetrical appearance, and the front side has a tendency to the right. It's crooked and not straight. And on the right, the perfectly shaped front. Then we have other differences inside the guns. When we... Oh no, I forgot one. On the newer model you can look through the ejection port. The slide on the right is thinner than on the older Makarov, where you can't see through. You can also see that this slide on the right is a lot thicker than on the newer model. When we take the guns apart, we will also see differences. The first thing you notice is that the recoil spring on the older model is longer. This one is the original recoil spring and this one was shortened. Then we have the slides. You can see that at the top the slide from the older one differs also from the newer one. The newer one is rough in the inside, and on the older one you can see machining marks. And what I think is that this slide is forged iron, where the CNC machine removed the metal inside, and the newer one is cast iron. You can also see the machining marks on the older style beneath the safety lever. These circles where the CNC machine removed the material. On the newer one you have this rough texture, like on the inside and the inside. And we have a different shaped firing pin. The newer one is a bit thicker at the end, and the older one is shaped more like a needle. The only differences on the frames and barrels is the rifling. They also have different rifling. Hope you can see this. The rifling is slightly shaped different. These are all differences on the pistols. The magazines also have a few ones. You can see on the left side the older magazine, and on the right side the newer one. The newer one has the magazine follower rest, which makes the loading easier. And the magazine loading holes or loading gate on the older one is smaller. You can't load lead BBs inside the older magazines, but you can on the newer ones. There's also you can also buy aftermarket items for the Makarovs. You can mount you can install all kinds of real grips, like pierce grips, and you can buy, for example, these screws here when you don't like this hanging around. You can unscrew them and replace them with these screws here. And that's it.